Our next guest is a professor of science and society and emeritus professor of fertility studies at Imperial College London. He holds 23 honorary doctorates, a seat in the House of Lords, and is the author of this absolutely brilliant book, Ask a Scientist. And we are honored tonight that he's here to teach us all about science. Please welcome Professor the Lord Robert Winston. Robert, bless you for being here. We are so happy. Now, we've all got lab coats on and we are ready for some science. So, okay. What are you going to teach us?
Right, so we're going to talk about food.
And okay.
And it was just thinking about an English breakfast and, what we tend to have is eggs.
Yes.
I like my eggs boiled. Mm-hmm. I quite like hard-boiled eggs.
Uh-huh.
Now, one of the ways is storing eggs, so you can put them in bottles and hold them there. And I want you to demonstrate to the audience how well you can keep that egg intact whilst putting it in the bottle.
Right, I don't... Well, that's... Yeah, but it's not... Look, that's... Yeah, that's not...
Yes,
it's that seems impossible. Yeah, that's me. Okay, so you teach me how it's done.
Right, so basically, you take your egg, and as you rightly did, you put the pointy end in, which is a bit easier that way. There we are. And you make a nice seal. Now, this bottle is not empty, it's full of air. And the air is nitrogen and oxygen, that's all. So if you use up the oxygen with a little fire, and if you watch the egg very carefully, it'll shudder as the air expands with the heat and it comes out through the side of the egg. This is where I'm going to burn myself.
This won't go for
you. Very frightening. Usually I have to go to hospital afterwards.
Okay.
I see it shuddering. So basically, the oxygen's gone, and therefore, without the oxygen and with just nitrogen left, which has mostly escaped because it's got expanded, when it cools down, it produces a vacuum.
That is a great tip for any of us who want to get our eggs in a bottle. That really, really is. I love it. That's absolutely incredible. Okay. What have we got next? What have we got here?
Dessert, possibly, the end of the meal.
Yes, I love a dessert.
You like gummies?
I do.
I heard that. Why don't you have one?
Have a gummy?
I'm not going to eat them if you don't
mind.
Is
this a real gummy or one of Reggie's?
It's a real gummy.
Is this a real one? Okay.
It's a real gummy. So basically, what we're going to do now is to show you what's happening inside your stomach as you're eating that.
What's happening when I eat this?
Yes.
In my stomach.
So let me give you 5 of these.
Okay.
I think it would be sensible because, you are handling food to wear gloves.
Okay.
Right.
And do we need these goggles as well? Is that why they're there? Do we need the goggles?
I think you probably should have the goggles. I can stand well back. I'll be all right. But I'll just to join in.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
So what's in here?
It's potassium chlorate, which is a highly oxidizing reaction with the sugar in the sweet, but it's not so dissimilar from the acid in your stomach.
So you're saying when I put these in there, this is what's happening in my stomach when I eat
almost the equivalent
sugar.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, here we go. Stand back. Here we go. Whoa! Sounds the same?
Very similar.
That is absolutely incredible. Thank you. What an incredible thing. And I shan't go near those gummies again. Bless you. All right. What have we got over
right,
here,
so
Professor? Okay.
Yep. So, one of the issues is about this dreadful weather in Los Angeles, which causes so much trouble. we're going to have a very hot week coming up. We had a hot week about 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Well, one of the things that you really need in Los Angeles is snow.
So we're
going to make snow, and we're going to cover the whole of Brentwood down there, you see, in this little model.
Right. So what have we got in here? What's this?
What we've got in here is sodium polyacrylate, which is a very, very hygroscopic material. That means it sucks up water and it expands with the water. So this is used in all sorts of, if you've got a camera lens you want to keep dry, you use this sort of stuff to get rid of the moisture. But actually, it's mostly used in babies' diapers.
This is what's in babies' diapers because it absorbs water.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So what are we going to do? We're going to pour the water here, and we're going to bring snow to Los Angeles. Okay. Here we go. It's so that would be Los Angeles. And then this is London around January. That's it. There we go. Look at that, a Christmas miracle. Now, tell me, Professor, what are we going to do now?
We're now going to, having made snow and rain, we're going to make a rainbow. A rainbow in Los Angeles.
A rainbow right here in the studio. Now, if you've been watching, you will realise the band have taken quite a turn in their outfits tonight. If Aaron Paul walks back into the studio, he's going to think we're doing, like, a Breaking Bad tribute. So, we need six of us for this, right? Because there's six colours in the rainbow, is that correct?
That's right. I think Aaron Paul actually is very lucky to be where he is, frankly. This is serious stuff. Serious, very serious.
Well, if it's serious stuff, there's an additional man we need. Ian Carmel, you're going to come and join us for this. So get your suit on. What do we need to do now, Professor?
We're going to open the curtains.
Open the curtain! Here we go. All right, come down and join us, guys. Here we go. So, OK, hang on, Robert, tell me. So why is the band doing this and Ian doing this? Why is Reggie not doing this?
Because Reggie is needed. CVS are really rather keen on him. They think he's the one person here who's indispensable.
That is an absolute outrage. Well, Reggie, why don't you come and join the professor down here and I will make my way over here to make a rainbow. Now, talk to us about the science here, Professor. What have we got around us?
Well, you should have six barrels there. One bucket contains liquid nitrogen at about minus 100, 200 degrees Celsius or 300 degrees Fahrenheit, roughly speaking.
Minus 300, that is incredibly cold.
Yeah. You pour that first into the bucket, and then we're going to put in that, after that, we're going to put in hot water very quickly, so the difference in temperature will be about 400 degrees Fahrenheit.
OK.
And then we'll make our rainbow.
All right, so what should we do first?
You can pour the liquid nitrogen in now.
Here we go. OK, is everybody ready? Nice, OK.
Be careful.
Wow, that is cold. I haven't seen anything this cold since I bumped into Guillermo in a restaurant outside of work. Actually, a true story. I've never seen anyone pretend they didn't know me more.
Get ready with the hot water, but don't pour it in until I say so.
OK.
And we're going to count... We'll get the audience to count to three, and on the count of three, I'll blow the whistle, and then get the hot water in as rapidly as you can.
All right, I just want to say, before we do this, Guillermo, Steve, Ian, Agar, Tim, we've had a great run. It's been great knowing you. Reg, I wish you luck with the future of the show. Good luck, brother.
And we salute your bravery.
OK.
So on the count of three, you pull this in when I blow the whistle.
OK.
So, one, two, three.
Oh, my God! Holy
We can just disappear.
Oh, my God! I can't see it. Step forward! Everybody, step forward!
That's amazing. That's pretty good.
Step on. We did it. We made it. We made. We're alive. We made a rainbow, gang. Get in here. Our thanks to Professor the Lord Robert Winston. His brilliant book, Ask a Scientist, available right now. We'll be right back, everybody.